Hello, welcome to Guy's Cooking Class. This is our third video. Today we are going to do a traditional French dessert, chocolate mousse. So I'm going to show you the ingredients we're going to use to do the dessert. First, we need cream and heavy cream, that is, and milk, butter, chocolate, dark chocolate preferably. We're going to use also some sugar, egg white. And then I have a little brittle that I made with different nuts and sugar. We're going to use it also as a garnish. And to finish the whole thing, we are using something called the langue de chat, which is a traditional French cookie, but you can do any cookie you want. The recipe of the langue de chat would be also printed and give it to you when you need it. Okay, thank you. We're going to start. So to melt the chocolate, we are using double water. In French, we call it bain-marie. Okay, so you have water in one of the pot and the chocolate in another. You make sure you do that because it's otherwise not very good to melt, to try to melt the chocolate on open fire. You are going to make it become granulated and it's not good. On the same time, because we do not want to mix two different types of temperature, hot and cold, we are bringing the cream and the milk to a boiling point. So, the butter is also room temperature, so we need to add the butter at the last minute. Because again, we do not want for the chocolate to become, you know, you see it's very limpid, very nice, so that's perfect, okay? So, my cream and milk is just about to boil, I'm going to stop it, and then we're going to mix it with the chocolate. Be very gentle with it. As we are doing that, we are going to add the butter as well. You see, you have a rich cream that you are forming. It's called a ganache, okay? That's the French word, the technical word that we use in the pastry for a cream such as chocolate, cream, and milk. Here there is an addition of butter. And then we're going to add also a four egg yolk little later on, okay? Not quite yet. Okay, so this mixture is ready. Now we're going to stir the egg white. Now the eggs are separated. We have the egg white right there. So, first you put the sugar. Usually we put the sugar after when we do egg white, but here you want the mixture to be homogeneous and you want it to be very airy. Okay, so that's why we do that. The sugar at the beginning would help to do that. So I put the egg white and then I turn on the machine. So first, I hope you can hear me, you start at a low speed and then progressively you augment the speed of the egg white and sugar mixture. One thing I forgot to tell you because I had them in the fridge and they were not with the ingredients is that we are going to add also 4 egg yolks, okay? So those 4 egg yolks are going to go with the chocolate in a minute. You see the cream with the addition of the egg yolk now start to get together very well. You know, it separated a little bit when I added the butter, but now it's getting back together very, very nicely. So the egg white, you can look really that they start to be really, really nice. Huh? They are not too hard. They are ready to do what we call in our jargon soft peak. Okay? So they will stay together, but they are not too hard. So that is what we are reaching right now. The idea with the chocolate mousse is that you want to keep it airy. And in order to do so, you do not want to break the egg white, okay? So the best way to do that is to take a little bit of the egg white mixture, like so, and add it to the chocolate. So what we are doing here is that we are getting the chocolate a little more loose, if you want. You know, the texture is going to get softer. So we want to make sure we incorporate that very, very well. It takes 3 minutes. Well, as you can see, I do not use a whisk, because a whisk is something that is too thin, is going to break the texture. So you don't want to do that. You want to keep it airy, as I say. So you just use a wooden spoon. And any little pieces that are not incorporated well, you just make sure you do it. Okay, so this is one first batch, you see, we are almost done. So then, take a little more, continue to incorporate the egg white with the mixture. It's nice to do also this type of movement, you know, where you really do not break the white, you just incorporate them. Point, because my casserole is little small anyway, we are going to bring everything back into this one. And here we are going to change the tool we are using. Instead of using a wooden spoon, we are going to use a rubber spatula. So everybody has a rubber spatula at home. Me, I have a few. I'm going to use the big one we have here. And then we are going to mix this whole thing together nicely, gently, because as I say, you do not want to break it. Look at that, very nice. And I noticed that I have a little bit of chocolate that's been into my jacket, which is not very professional. I knew this gentleman in Paris named Mr. Lynx. Mr. Lynx owned La Maison du Chocolat, which is one of the best chocolate places in Paris and in the world. And I saw Mr. Lynx walking the chocolate. He would start the day with a white jacket, white apron, and he would go home at night, and he was still white on both sides. And I could not understand how he could manage to make such wonderful things with chocolate and be so clean at the end of the day. So that's something I have not managed, obviously. Up, here we are. Our mousse is ready. So we're going to bring it here. We are going to now put it in a little container. Here I have some little coffee cup, nice little coffee cup. Let's make about 6 portions of mousse, okay? So I'm going to use a ladle. Old-fashioned little. Now, as you see, because we have a little baby here, you know, who's a year and a half, and we don't want to give him that because he's going to break it, so we're going to give him that instead, okay? And we are still going to make the mousse for him. Okay, that's going to be the first one I'm making. See, we fill it to the 3/4. You can see, I don't know if you can see it on the screen, but you can see that its mousse is very, very smooth and very airy, you know. As I said before, you want to make sure it's airy. So you see, I say make 6, but I tell you one thing, you can make probably 7 out of that. If I put, of course, a little more If you fill it to the top, I guess you could make that meal. So you know what I have to do? Okay. So that's it. Then we are going to clean the side. We're going to put it in the fridge, and that's going to stay like this for about 2 hours. An hour is good, but 2 hours will be fine. Okay, it will be more solid, and then we're going to do the decoration on our chocolate mousse. Okay, we'll see you in a few minutes. All right, welcome back. Our chocolate mousse is ready. As you can see, it's all set. This is about 2 hours since we made them. And we are going to put the garnish on the top. Here I'm going to use a little bit of creme fraiche and make a quenelle with it. A quenelle is a little football shape cream. You can use, if you don't have that, you can use some whipped cream, that's fine. Or no cream at all. And on the top of it, we are going to put the brittle we made yesterday.
How did you make and the brittle?
And the brittle, we make it with caramel and nuts. Any type of nuts you have in the house, you just fold them with the caramel, let it cool down, and then you just process it in the cuisine art. That's it. So, and then we're going to garnish with a little cookie that we call the langue de chat. As we say langue de chat in English?
It is cat's tongue.
Cat's tongue.
It looks like a cat's tongue.
Okay. So we're going to attach the recipe of the cat's tongue as well, okay? Like this, you can do it, okay? So I'm going to make the quenelle. So to make the quenelle, you need some hot water. I started to make them. The hot water, you have to be very, very hot. You bring it to a bowl, and then, you know, with the spoon, we just make a nice little, you know, football shape that we put on the top of our mousse, okay? And of course, I have the one for Alex. I don't know where is Alex right now. I think he's on the floor playing with his toys. So we're going to make a little one for Alex as well. That's it, okay? So that being done, we're going to put the garnish. So Mariah,
all
you
right,
can take care
so
of that.
So I will take care of the garnish with a little bit of the nuts on top of each one. Not too much, enough to sort of give a little extra flavor to the mousse. And I think I need that one as well.
Sorry.
And
so
that.
And this one you have, okay, so we have to go for this one.
And then, oops, that one. And then the langue de chat.
Yes, you just stick the langue de chat like so.
Langue de chat.
Okay. And our mousses are ready. So you see, it's simple, something you can do with the whole family. And let me tell you a little bit about the chocolate as well. Here I use a dark chocolate. The one I use is very, very nice. It's called Valrhona, okay? And it's called the noir de Valrhona, the black
oui.
Valrhona. And if you have any good baking chocolate at home, you can use that. I just happen to have this delicious one because I love good chocolate. And this is our mousse. Next, bon appétit, hein? Oh, you cannot wait. Oh, look at that. You see, the mousse is very smooth, it's very nice. Don't you like it?
Good.
Good? You just say good. I like the crunch. I like the smoothness of the mousse. And then our little cookie complete the whole thing. So, did you try the cookie, Alex? Try the cookie. No, you want the mousse. Okay, well, bon appétit.